people are very upset about the Postal Service delays, the cutbacks in service, some of the equipment removals, and the fact that overtime for many of the workers has been cut back. So people worry it's going to affect mail-in balloting, that the ballots will not arrive in time. People have medicine that gets delivered via the mail. That is being compromised. So people are very unhappy with the poor service that we're getting from the Postal Service.
So then, given the delays that we've already seen, and from what you heard from the Postmaster General, how confident are you that things will go smoothly given the pandemic and the perhaps increased number of people who may be using mailed-in ballots?
I'm personally worried about how it's going to go in November, because in 2016, about one quarter of Americans voted via the mail, but we estimate that could rise to 50 to 60% of Americans. So there's going to be multiple millions of people sending their ballots through the mail. They need to arrive on time. And given the service cutbacks, I think it's very much in question whether the Postal Service is going to be able to deliver things on time. And that could challenge the integrity of the election.
Now, as we know, Mr. DeJoy, a huge donor to President Trump's campaign. Now, he has been the Postmaster General for only 70 days. As you mentioned, there have been issues with delays, and he does have a history, though, with logistics and supply chains. What does his leadership bring to the table, for better or worse?
Well, he certainly has experience in logistics, but people are worried about the fact that he is a large donor to President Trump's campaign. And so they worry that he is politicizing an institution that always has been viewed in nonpartisan terms. People have not really doubted the political motivations of the people who are running the post office. But with this individual, given the service cutbacks just a few months prior to a major national election, that raises a lot of doubts in the minds of people.
Because a lot of people did have questions about seeing their mailboxes getting removed or getting sorting machines removed from the Postal Service. How much of that is sort of regular turnover versus something perhaps more targeted, given that this is an election year?
Well, there certainly have been equipment removals in the past, even under President Obama, that was the case. But what we're seeing now is equipment removals that are dropping the service delivery on time numbers by up to 10 percentage points. So that's a very substantial drop in a very short period of time. And given the fact that people now are counting on the mail for all sorts of things, the delivery of food, the delivery of medicine, e-commerce is taking off as well. And then, of course, the ballots in terms of our upcoming national election. So that's what really is creating all the concern right now.
Now, something that we keep hearing about from the Trump administration is this issue of profitability. So just how much of a priority is profitability for the USPS? And what are some of the misconceptions surrounding this issue?
The U.S. Postal Service is running a large deficit, but part of it is because several years ago, Congress forced that organization to start to put all the money in for the retirement fund right away, as opposed to at the point at which people retire. Overnight, that created billions of dollars of deficits for the Postal Service. And so, in part, this is a policy-inflicted deficit. I mean, there certainly are changes in the competition, and there are private providers that are creating real issues for the Postal Service. But part of its deficit is self-imposed by the U.S. Congress.
Now, I want to look at some of these private companies and perhaps also the USPS's relationship with e-commerce companies and other companies. How would you characterize that relationship?
The Postal Service does provide a lot of service to the major e-commerce firms, including Amazon, but that is becoming a more complicated relationship because Amazon is now developing its own delivery service. So they contract with private truckers and other people who can ship their items across the country. So that is creating some business problems for the U.S. Postal Service. Trump argues that Amazon is not paying enough. He claims they're getting a cut rate deal, and that's part of the financial issues. So I think after this election, you know, we do have to take a look at the business model, but we need to do it in a bipartisan manner and not in an overtly political manner.